Assalamualaikum, grade 5. As we were discussing about heat, light and sound, we have completed this chapter. Now this is overview and review of your chapter, heat. First of all, we are going to discuss about the heat, as it is described as the total energy of all particles within an object. It is the form of energy that can move from the hotter object to the cooler one. You can see the 1 liter of water will heat quicker than the 2 liter because the particle will be more in 2 liter. The temperature is an indicator of how hot or cold something is. The hotter substances have particles that are moving faster. In this we recall the conductor and insulators. An electrical conductor is a substance that allows electricity or heat to pass through them, whereas example are copper, aluminium, platinum, gold, silver, water, pupil and animal's tree. Now the electrical insulator, we discuss about them, material that do not allow heat and electricity, like glass, porcelain, plastic, rubber. So conduction, you can see in metals, the insulator, you should see in wood, plastic. But they both have a great importance in our life. If you talk about the uses, you can see for a cooking pan we need a conductor, but to hold it we need a insulator. So insulator, like these gloves, you need that to hold the hot object. A rabbit has a fur, they are insulator. It keeps its body warm in cold environment. These penguin, the electric current, they have the base made up of metal and the handle made up of insulator. Then we discuss about the transfer method. There are three types of method by which heat can be transferred: conduction, convection and radiation. These three methods, how they happen? In conduction, you can see it happens usually in solid, like that you keep a spoon in hot water and after that you feel at the top, or you are not allowed to pick that because of heat transfer. It is a rod made up of iron, and when you heat one end slightly, it will reach to the end. You can see the movement of molecule in each. Now they are heating the atom, they are passing the energy to the neighboring molecule, and the time will come, the whole rod will become hot and it is not easy to pick down. The good conductors are materials. So the all material which perform the function of conduction, they are conductor. Convection happens usually liquid and gases. It is the phenomena in which a current is created, which is known as convection current. You can see in this picture, the hotter air go up because it is lighter, and the air which is less, which is cold, it come to the down. So it create a current which is known as convection current. Basically what happened, when the molecule get heat energy, they move away and they carry the energy with them. And this is why this process is going on and known as convection current. Through this, the liquid and gases can get heat energy. Now the third one, radiation. As you know, it is a picture of sun. You receive the energy. If there are animals, they will also receive the energy. So if the rays are involved, or if the energy is transferred in the form of waves, the transfer of matter will call radiation. Conduction, convection and radiation, you can see if the environment is getting hot, so it is radiation. The water is boiling inside it, it is convection, and the whole pot is getting energy because of conduction. You can see convection, conduction and radiation. The dark color objects get more energy because they are the good absorber, whereas the light colors reflect more radiation, so they are not good object to receive the most heat energy. That is why we wear the light color clothes in summer season and we wear the dark color clothes in winter season. Then we discuss about the light. Light is also the type of energy. The light always travel in a straight line. The speed of light is 300,000 km per second. And the speed of light is much faster than the speed of sound. Then we discuss about the luminous and non-luminous object. The object that has, like sun, lamp, their own energy, their own light, known as luminous. Whereas the objects that do not have their own light, they are known as reflector. So because of reflection, we can see each and everything.